Everything you say is correct. I mean, I turn your tapes on. I'm one of those over and over and over you were talking about, because you have such a command about your voice. I love it.
Well, what you're hearing is, you can tell that we know what we know.
Yeah.
But what you're feeling is that at another level, you know it too.
See, I don't know that yet.
We know that you know, and as you hear it, you know it in that moment. That's why it feels like that to you.
That's why it feels good. My health. My mother taught me to really worry. Okay, enough said about the family environment and all that stuff. Okay, so I've gotten away. I've gotten into better health by, I'm better at not worrying. But I realized yesterday, I can worry subconsciously.
Well, here's the thing. If you have an unconscious worry, and you're not feeling any emotion around it, then it's not a big player in your vibration. If you are feeling an emotion around it, it's not subconscious.
Oh.
And if you're feeling it, and it's not subconscious, then you have the conscious ability to choose a thought that feels better.
Sure. Until I found your tapes and your book, I realized because of the money issues and my health is bad, etc., it's really bad. I would wake up, and I lost, my raccoon decided to live on its own. And I would wake up, and instead of having him to play with, I'd just start worrying. And so I've tried to stop that with your tapes. And I realized yesterday, okay, I spent 45 minutes worrying. How is that going to hurt me today?
Well, it isn't really going to hurt you. That's just 45 minutes that you're not allowing the well-being to flow. Think of it in terms of well-being trying to make its way to you. And in your worry, you've got a little resistor on it that's not quite letting it all flow. That's all. You have a lot of leeway. So don't monitor yourself and don't fret over your thoughts. We sometimes see our physical friends offering a negative statement and then they try to suck it back in. They're worried that the universe will get hold of it. And we say, you have enormous leeway. Just relax in this and do your best to reach for a thought that feels better. Now let us give you something here, because you see, you have this range of vibration within you at any point in time. And let's say something has happened that has been very troubling, and so you feel very angry about something because it's just right there in your face. And then one of your friends who's studying the science of deliberate creation says, oh, you know, you create your own reality and you shouldn't think like that because you're messing up your future experience, and you just sort of like to punch their lights out because they're all bright and fluffy and shiny and you don't feel anything like that, because whatever has your attention has you in this vibrational pattern. So you can't get from where you are to over there in one fell swoop, any more than you can set your radio dial on 101 FM and hear 97.6. You're not on the same vibrational wavelength. So what you do is you stand right where you are, and your range is really, really angry to a little less angry. But you're angry. You've just got different degrees of anger. You don't have appreciation anywhere in your range or love anywhere in your range. Not right now. You're angry. What you're focused upon has you there. So you just reach for the least angry thought you can find. And as you find the least angry thought that you can find, as you try to give somebody the benefit of the doubt, or as you step away from it a little bit, you reach for the least angry thought that you can find. And if you can hold that for as little as 17 seconds, that lesser angry thought will become your mid-range. And now the true anger went out of range, and something even a little better feeling came into range. So you reach for that best feeling thought that you can, and you hold it for as little as 17 seconds, and it becomes your mid-range, which means anger is sort of leaving you, and now you're into mild frustration. So you reach for the mild frustration, and you hold that thought, it becomes your center point. And now the really angry thoughts are gone altogether, and now you have access to a little bit of appreciation. So now you reach for the little bit of appreciation, you hold it for as little as 17 seconds, and now anger and frustration are sort of out of range, and feeling a little better and appreciation. And so with a little bit of effort, in 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 10 minutes, you can move your vibration dramatically, but you can't make the jump.
I see.
So that's what we mean by reach for the thought that feels best. Reach for the thought that feels best. And the only way this game works, and it is important that it does work, is when you say, it really does matter how I feel. Because how I feel is my indicator of whether I'm letting it in or not. Letting what in? My clarity, my inner being, my source energy, my wellness, the abundance that I'm wanting. In other words, it all comes through my vibration. So that's why you hear stories like someone who's very, very, very sick, on the brink of death, and we say, not really on the brink of death, if you were really on the brink of death, you would have gone, but it's the words that you use. Not allowing well-being to flow.
That's
watching funny movies and recovering. Or going into a coma and waking up better. Or going to someone who they believe in and having a faith healing. Or taking a drug that they believe in and having a drug healing. Or, in other words, you have a lot of different things that you use as your excuse to no longer resist. But it is always the same thing. It is the ceasing of resistance that then allows the well-being that is natural to you.
I'm a resister, and I've always been a maverick. Not bragging.
Well, maverick is good. You come from a family of mavericks. We are that too. And what we mean by maverick is we don't do anything to please others, and that makes them label us all mavericks. They would far rather that we be lovable pleasers, all of us. Everyone wants to love. And if you will stand on your head to make someone love you, then they think that that's good, and they think everybody should be that way. And the ones that refuse to do that are almost always labeled mavericks. And they usually end up in a 12-step program, too. Because you have the combination of this. You have the combination of knowing that you are the creator of your own experience, and it's not your job to please them. And you also have the desire to be an uplifter. So the maverick in you causes you to be your own person and not please them, and the uplifter in you makes you suffer for what they think of the maverick choices that you are making. You see?
Got me tagged.